chapter, so this is about objects. Another concept that's very relevant. Objects are things. So this is not about object-oriented programming. Maybe you are experts in object-oriented programming or Java or not. Anyhow, this is not about. Objects in Artemoy are things. Things that feature in task performances. So in the coffee shop, a typical object is a card that I got with two stamps and that I suppose I have to bring it back and get more stamps maybe, right? So this is an object that features in the task domain. And there are more, right? Not object. They could be physical things, but they could also be non-material things like messages. So I have sent each of you a message with the login for the electronic learning environment for task analysis. This message is an object because I sent the message to you. And if you didn't get the message, you ask your colleague, can you forward the message to me? So the object can be handed over, even if the object is not in any way physical. It's electronic, what is it, right? Okay, but objects could even be gestures, right? I mean, if I meet, then I could say hi, right? And so if we see each other at the end of the square, I wave to Frank and Frank will wave back, right? So a gesture could be something that features in our communication. And a password is an object. By the way, each of you got a password, a separate password for the network. And because I mailed the password, you should be aware I know your passwords. I won't use them, but I know them, right? Okay. But stories could be objects. I told you a story about my trip to Alghero and my problems with the bus ticket. You can tell the story to somebody else, and you can say, Gerrit told me the story of. So this is an object that we can hand over between people, right? And even signatures can be objects. And some people know my passwords. Like Ellie knows my password, but she won't tell it to anybody, or you should pay her a lot of money. Okay. Be careful. In any business, there are many objects that you would like to model and it doesn't make sense. Only if objects can be shared between agents as a result of activity delegation, only in that case objects make sense. So you should not object the coffee cup if it's nothing happens with it. But the ticket with the stamps, something happened with it, right? And it has a meaning. So this is an object to model. So if they're shared, and maybe the menu on the desk where people are doing things with the menu. So objects and the person at the desk, he's getting slips of paper out of the machine, I think, and he's putting them somewhere in a clip. I would like to know what's going on with the clip later on, right? So there's things here. This clip plays a very important role here. So these are objects that you should model. And they are related to roles, so a certain agent can do things. Somebody can inspect the objects. I guess the sheets of paper that go in the clip will be inspect. Maybe somebody is allowed to throw it away, but somebody else not. Maybe there's a copycat. So find out what happens with these type of objects. Right? What happened with the card when it's full, what happened with the slip that's in the clip, and so on. So this is just a picture. Actually, this happens to me, my object in my desk in Amsterdam a couple of years ago. It's now much cleaner. Ellie, true?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So what can you see here? Well, there's a fax. There's a paper perforator. I'm not sure you know, but this machine makes holes in paper, and then I could put something through the holes, a binder to put paper together. This is a stepper. It puts staples in sheets of paper. This is just a pile, but this pile I use when making telephone calls. This box contains magnetic paper clips. So the box is magnetic and it contains paper clips to put paper together. And this thing I just put there for papers not to be blown away. So these are all aspects to keep things together. And some of them keep them together temporarily, like the clip. And sometimes are to make them for good, like the stapler. If I put two documents, if a stapler, they are now one document. The same you can do with Word files or PDF files. Or I can put an Excel spreadsheet in a Word file. So I'm combining objects, making a new object, and then I'm handing over this object to somebody else. So you can see objects can play a big role in a task system. And electronic objects behave like the paper objects. Some things you can easily separate again. Sometimes when you put them together, you can no longer separate. If you want something to be completely together, you make a PDF. It's much more difficult. It's not impossible, but much more difficult to separate the things again, right? Okay, so this is why objects are very important. And then we have events. Unexpected things that trigger for something to be performed. So, for instance, if there is a shutdown of a file server, unpredicted, that's an event. It's not part of the task, but it happens, and then we should know what to do. Or as an invitation to write a chapter. I wasn't waiting for that, but somebody tells me, can you write a chapter for this book? This is an event. Or sometimes I read a journal, and in the journal is a call for papers for a conference, I think. This is nice. Let me, so that I'm triggered from something from outside. And events have problems if there is no agent appointed or feeling responsible. So, if there's an event, but there's already a task waiting, then there's no problem. In the coffee shop, if somebody else enters and asks for a coffee, it's no problem because they are waiting for the task to perform, right? So this is not an event. If all of a sudden they will run out of water, or the electricity falls down and the machine doesn't work, that's an event. Because now this is something uncommon, but they have to run their business, okay? So then we model events, only when events are unpredicted and unaccounted for, but you still have to handle, right? So like I think this was yesterday when the water stopped in the campus, right? So we wanted to take a shower and all of a sudden there was no water anymore. This is an event, right? Mm-hmm. So, okay.